The Carolina Hurricanes are the focus of today's 30 and 30 series. Matt Wehmeyer, alongside Dan Rosen, and Dan, the Canes have missed the playoffs in 7 straight seasons. They have just one total playoff appearance since winning the Cup in 2006. And to say the least, General Manager Ron Francis not shy about giving this roster a pretty big makeover.
No, and I think the key addition is Teuvo Teravainen, very young player, fits in with that youngerish core that Carolina has with Jordan Staal and Jeff Skinner and Elias Lindholm and Victor Rask among the forwards. Teravainen, you know, has great upside. Plus, he has a Stanley Cup championship too, so that's key. He learned under tutelage in Chicago from guys like Jonathan Toews. That will help. Now, what Carolina coach Bill Peters needs to figure out, is he a center? Or is he a wing? I think he could be a center, and I think it'll be very important if he is a center for this team, but he has great upside, as I said. Now, Brian Bickle, who came along in that trade with the Blackhawks to come to Carolina, he's got a chance to rejuvenate his career in the last year of a 4-year deal. Lee Stempniak signed a free agent contract. I think he could score 20 goals for Carolina, and that would be a pretty good bargain at $2.5 million. And Victor Stahlberg knows his role as a bottom six forward, and he'll help this team as well. Overall, I like the changes from Ron Francis.
So for all the new names and new faces on this roster heading into next season, one very familiar presence remains that, of course, goaltender Cam Ward.
Yeah, and consistency has just been a problem for Cam Ward. And we look at it, last season he had a .909 save percentage. That's got to go up. That's a problem. The good news is in the last 30 games last season, he had a .919 save percentage. So it did go up, but the start that he had doomed him, and it doomed the Carolina Hurricanes. If he establishes some consistency at the start of the season, it will help this team as it pushes to try to get into the playoffs. There's also Eddie Lack there, but Cam Ward back, $3.3 million instead of the $6-plus million he was making. That's good for them. He just needs to have some consistency throughout the season.
So the Canes throwing a lot of new ingredients, if you will, into this blender, hoping it produces a winning team. Your biggest concern about them right now is what?
Well, I think it has to be the offense, and will they be able to score enough to compete for that playoff spot? I look at one key stat for the Carolina Hurricanes. Last season, they led the league in one-point losses, overtime shootout. So they got a point in those games, but they lost the second point. 16 of those points were lost. If they win half of those games, they are a 93-point team on the cusp of the playoffs. If they win three-quarters of those games, they're a 97-point team, and they're in the playoffs. So it's not going to take a huge amount of offensive improvement because of the way that Bill Peters coaches this team and the possession game that they do play and how they limit scoring chances. But they need to generate more scoring chances, more quality scoring chances. They need to put the puck in the net a little bit more.
So as you touched on, Carolina finishing 7 points off the pace for that final playoff spot last season. Do they make up that ground this coming spring?
I think they'll make up some of that ground, but I don't think they'll make up all of it. Again, I think they're very much like the New Jersey Devils in that they're a team on the rise, on the cusp, but I don't have them in the playoffs right now.